topic is a fixed substance. Let's see Quranic ayahs and detail about it. Nahmadu nusalli ala rasulihil kareem. Amma baad, fa'uz billahi minash shaitan rajeem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So let's see the ayah of the Quran. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Yas'aluhu man fis samawati wal ard kullu yawmin huwa fi shanin. Whoever in heaven and earth begs to him every day, he has a matter to bring forth, such as giving honor to some, disgrace to some, life to some, death to some. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made man fis samawati wal ard kullu yawmin huwa shan, and whatever Allah wants. And here the another ayah of the Quran, وَمَا ظَلَمْنَاهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Here Allah says, we wronged them not, but they were the wrongdoers. So here we see, before ayah we see, so Allah the Most High controls the affair of His creation, encouraging His ruling sometimes according to His wisdom and the beneficence, and sometimes according to His wisdom and justice. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never treats anyone unjustly. And here, this is the surah we have seen in this, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining the following ayahs. The previous one was Suratul Rahman, ayah number 29. And now this ayah is Suratul Zukhruf. And this is ayah number 76. وَمَا ظَلَمْنَاهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا هُمُ الظَّالِمِينَ. We wronged them not, but they were the wrongdoers. See, وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا هُمُ الظَّالِمِينَ. So, we believe in Allah and His Qadr, and believe in Allah's pre-decree. It's one of the pillar of Iman. So, we believe that whatever good or state of ease and security comes upon us, then it is from Allah's blessing upon us, and it is an obligation upon us that we give praise and thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one who grant everything to us. And this is done by returning to that obedience to Him and avoiding whatever He forbid and doing whatever He ordered. If we carry out our duty to obedience to Allah, then we will be giving as a thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His blessing, and would then deserve the increase in this blessing which Allah has promised us from His bounty, and Allah the Mighty and Majestic. But here, وَمَا بِكُمْ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ, and whatever of the blessing and good things that you have, it is from Allah. So here we see, it says whatever the blessings and good things is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here Utaimi said that this is the, you know, half of the faith is like we believe in it. Whatever is given, whatever the blessing and good things you have, it is from Allah. وَمَا بِكُمْ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. And here we see Faminallah, and this is from Suratul Nahl, ayah number 53. And there is one more ayah in Suratul Ibrahim, ayah number 7. وَإِسْتَعَزَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ أَزَابِ لَشَدِيدٌ. And remember when your Lord proclaimed, if you give thanks, I will give you more my blessings. But if you are thankless, Allah will punish. His punishment is indeed severe. So here Allah says, as in a rabbukum la in shakartum, if you are thankful, la azidannakum is from ziyada, Allah will increase it. But what if wal in kafartum, like you are thankless? So that will be azabul shadid. You're going to have severe punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So further, we see ayah number 30, Suratul Shura. And in that we see, وما أصابكم من مصيبة فبما كسبت أيديكم ويعفو عن كثير. And whatever misfortune falls you, it is because of what your hands have earned. And He forgives you. Yaghfiru. Yaafu here. It's not Yaghfiru, it's Yaafu. So here we see Vama Asabakum. Whatever befalls, Mim Musibatim. Any misfortune falls. Why it is so? For Bima Kasabat. And here it's mentioned, it is because what your hands have earned. Bima kasabat. And what is aidikum? But Allah says, payafu an kasirin. But Allah can forgive you more. That too kasir. So we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more and more. So everyone goes through musibah, misfortune, some mishap, some distress, sorrow, grief. But what we have to do? Yafu. Allah is ready to forgive us. But we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more and more forgiveness. And here later we see Surah An-Nisa, ayah number 79. Zahar al-fasadu fil barri wal bahri bima kasabat aydin nasi liziqahum ba'da allazi amilu la'allahum yarji'un. Evil sins and disobedience of Allah has appeared on the land and sea because of what the hands of men has earned by oppression and evil deeds, that Allah may take them to a taste part of that which they have done in order that they may return repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here we see Zahar al-Fasadu means apparent, open facade, open whatever the thing appear on Barra and Bahar. An apparent thing. And why is it so? Because of the sin and disobedience to Allah. Bahar al-Fasad, which is on land and sea. Bahar and Bar. Bima Kasabat. Again, the same thing has been mentioned here. Bima Kasabat Aidi. Because of what the hands have earned. And oppression and evil deeds. Because annasi liyuziqahum. Yuziqahum is from zawq. Because of that, they are tasting what? Ba'dal lazi amilu. Whatever ba'dal lazi means make them test a part of that which they have done. Amilu is from amal. La'allahum yarjun. And why is it so? So that we all repent and go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whatever the open sin or disobedience to Allah, because of our bima kasabat aidi, because of our own hands. And then also Allah says, annasi liyuziqahum. You are tasting it, badal lazi amilu, whatever you did. But what the end result? La'allahum yarjiun. Allah is asking, come on, do the ruju. So we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then in this we learn any destruction, anything, any punishment, whether it was Aad, Samud, and now after so many years, if we are going through that hardship, what we have to do? We have to ask Allah forgiveness. That is because لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Let's see another ayah and details of this. Here we see it's a sunnah, the way of life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, consisting of his words, action and silent approval. Sunnah is content in the various authentic hadith. So we have to remember that, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned it. And here we see Suratul An'am 65 to 66. Qul huwal qadiru ala أن يبأس عليكم عذابا من فوقكم أو من تحت أرجلكم أو يلبسكم شيئا ويزيغ بعضكم بأس بعض انظر كيف نصرف الآيات لعلهم يفقهون وكذب به قومك وهو الحق قل لست عليكم بوكيل لكل نبأ مسحور وسوف تعلمون. He has to send torment. See, he has to send torment on you from above. So here Allah is saying, Azaban min fawqikum, above you, or from under you, or min tahti arjulikum, or to cover you with confusion in party strife and make you taste the violence of one another. أو تحتي أرجلكم أو يلبسكم شيئا ويزيق بعضكم بأس بعض to taste violence of one another. And Allah says, انظر كيف نصرف الآيات. See how variously we explain the ayah. لعلهم يفقهون, so that they may understand. So Allah is sending all this so that we may understand it. And then it says, وَكَذَّبَ بِهِ قَوْمُكَ وَهُوَ الْحَقُّ, but your people, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, have denied, كَذَّبُ, denied the Quran, though it is the truth. هُوَ الْحَقُّ, it is حَقُّ. قُلْ لَسْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْوَكِيلِ, say, I am not responsible for your affairs. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is just conveying the message and saying, I am not a wakil now, whatever you are doing. لِكُلِّ نَبَعٍ مُسْتَقِيلٍ فَقَرَّوْا وَسَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. Here it says, for every news, there is a fact. لِكُلِّ نَبَأ, any news, any, you know, every news. And it says, مُسْتَقَرَّوْا وَسَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ, for everything there is an appointed term and you will come to know. So here, what does it mean, appointed term and you will come to know? So we all have to die one day. When we gonna die? Allah knows. So that is the thing mentioned over here. قُلْ هُوَ قَادِرُ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَبْعَثُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابًا مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ. See, he has power to send torment on you from above you. So Allah is saying he can send the torment from above. Means Prophet ﷺ said, I seek refuge with your face. أَوْ مِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِكُمْ, or from your feet. Prophet ﷺ said, I seek refuge with your face. أَوْ يَلْبِسُكُمْ شَيْئًا وَيُزِيقُ بَعْدُكُمْ بَعْسًا بَعْدُ, or to cover you with confusion in party strife and make you to taste the violence of one another. Prophet ﷺ said, this is lighter or easier. It is reported by Muslim from Sa'id bin Abi Waqqas radiallahu anhu, who said, we went along with Allah's Messenger ﷺ until we came to the mosque of Banu Mawai, Mawia. So Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered and prayed 2 rak'ah. So we pray along with him. So he called upon his Lord for a long time. Then he said, I ask my Lord for 3 things. For 3 things he asked. What is it? I ask him that he should not destroy my nation. First thing he said, not to destroy it, nation with a deluge. So he granted me that. I ask him that he should not destroy my nation with famine, as happened to the people of Pharaoh. So he granted. So another thing was also granted. And I ask him that they should not fight among themselves, but he refused me that. And the third thing Rasulullah ﷺ asked, the nation should not fight between each other, but that was rejected. And from Qab ibn al-Arat radiallahu anhu, who said, I came to Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam on night in which he spent the whole of it in prayer until it was Fajr. So Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam concluded his prayer with Taslim. I said, oh Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you have prayed a prayer this night the like of which I have not seen you pray. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, indeed it was a prayer of hope and fear. In it, I ask my Lord, the Mighty and Majestic, for 3 things. He grant me 2 and refuse me 1. I ask my Lord, the Mighty and Majestic, that he should not destroy us with which he destroyed the nation. He granted. I ask my Lord, he should not overwhelm us with an enemy from other than us. So he granted. I ask my Lord, he should not cause us to divide into separate groups, each attacking the other. But he refused me that. Reported by Imam Ahmad, Nasai and Tirmizi. So what we learn from this, this was the dua rejected and we are divided so much. Allah. And here, قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَاسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وأحليهم يوم القيامة، ألا ذلك هو الخسران المبين. See, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the loser are those who will lose themselves and their families on the day of resurrection. Verily, that will be a manifest loss. So here in the Surah Zumar, ayah number 15, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the losers are those who will lose themselves and their families on the day of resurrection. Verily, that will be a manifest loss, isn't it? You know, قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَاسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. The losers are those who lose themselves. First of all, أَنفُسَهُمْ. وَأَحْلِيهِمْ. And also the family. When it is? يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. أَلَى ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ مُبِينَ. And superlative degree. خُسْران. More loss. And that is a manifest loss. An open loss. So here, one of awaiting fulfillment of one of the duties you have to make obligatory upon us, that you make us of those who take heed of your signs and receive admonition. So we should take the heed from this, and we should understand why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this ayah. There is so much to learn from this. We have seen different ayahs, and here there are a few more ayahs, then we'll finish this. So another here, walau anna ahla al-qur'a amanu wattaqu la fatahna alayhim bi barakatin minas samai. Here Allah is mentioning in Surah Al-Araf, ayah number 96 to 99. Here Allah says, and if people of the towns had believed and had taqwa piety, certainly we should have opened for them blessing from heavens and the earth. They belied the messengers, so we took them with punishment for what they used to earn, polytheism and crimes, etc. Did the people of towns then feel secure against the coming of our punishment by night? When they are asleep, the people of towns then feel secure against the coming of our punishment in the forenoon while they play. Did they then feel secure against the plot of Allah? None feel secure from the plot of Allah except the people who are lost. So we see this ayah in detail from ayah number 96 to 99. Palau an ahlal qura. Here, and if the people of the town, qura is the town, amanu wattaqu, of the town had believed and had taqwa, then Allah says, وَاتَّقُوا لَفَتَحْنَا. La is surely. Fatahna, we surely have opened, alayhim, upon them, بِبَرَكَاتٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. And Allah has opened the blessings, baraka, from where? مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, and earth, fill earth. And وَلَكِنْ كَذَّبُوا, but if they denied, walakin, but if they denied, فَأَقَزْنَاهُمْ, we will seize them, bima, because of what, kanu yaksibun, what they earn. Again here kasaba is mentioned, and previously also we have seen kasaba aidihim, because what they have earned because of their own thing. So what they used to earn, polytheism, crimes, shirk, all those things. فَآمَنْ مِنْ أَحْلُ الْقُرْآ. And when they feel themselves, you know, did the people of town then feel secure against the coming of our punishment? أَنْ يَعْتِهُمْ بَاسُنَا بَيَاتٌ وَهُمْ نَعِيمُونَ. When they are in the home and they are in the sleep, but Allah will catch them. أَوْ أَمِنَا أَحْلُ الْقُرَى أَنْ يَعْتِهُمْ بَاسُنَا دُوحًا وَهُمْ يَلْعَبُونَ. And here Allah says clearly, or do the people of town then feel secure against coming up for a punishment in the forenoon while they play? Afa aminu makarallahu fala ya'munu makarallahi illa qawmul khasirun. Allah said, did they then feel secure against the plot of Allah? None feel secure from the plot of Allah except the people who are lost. You know, they are khasirun. They are completely khasirun. They are complete losers because they forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah will catch hold of them. And Again, in Surah Al-Araf, ayah number 182 and 183, Sanas tazri juhum min haythu la ya'lamun wa umla lahum inna qayda matin. We shall gradually seize them with punishment in ways they perceive not, and I respite them, certainly my plot is strong. So here, gradually, Allah will catch hold of them with the punishment. Amla lahum inna qayda. And Allah says, and I respite them. Certainly my plot is matin, very strong plot, qayda. So Allah will catch hold of them. And here, Allah says, there is one more ayah of the Quran here, 104 and 105, Suratul Ali Imran. Let there arise out of you a group of people inviting to, that is, good Islam, enjoying the ma'ruf and forbidding the munkar. And it is those who are successful. What is the key for success? This is the thing we have to do. And be not as those who divided and differed among themselves after the clear proofs had come to them. If they, for them, there is an awful torment. So what we learn from this, here, this ayah, وَتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةً يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. For the success, we have to do أَمَرْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ نَهْيَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And these are the people, they will be مُفْلِحُونَ. They will be successful. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِي تَفَرَّقُوا. But as, and it is those who, and but as those who divided. Tafarruq is from faraqa. If they divided, then waqtalafu, and they not only divided among themselves after the clear proof had come to them, it is they for whom there is an awful torment. Because see, tafarruqu waqtalafu min badi ma jaahumul bayyinat. After clear proofs has came, what is the clear proof? Quran and Sunnah. Wa ulaika lahum azabun azim. Because they didn't take the clear proof seriously, so for them ulaika lahum azabun azim. For them is the azabun azim. And here we see in the ayah number, let's see following ayahs, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Suratul Hajj, ayah number 40 and 41, verily Allah will help those who help his cause. وَلَا يَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ. Barely Allah will help those who help his cause. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا قَوِيٌ عَزِيزٌ. Truly Allah is all strong, almighty. So those Muslim rulers who, if we give them power in the land, they order the establishment of prayer and the payment of zakat, and they enjoy the ma'ruf and forbid the munkar. Again the same thing mentioned in this Suratul Hajj ayah is also same as the previously which we have seen in the Ali Imran. And with Allah is the end of all matters of the creatures. Means Allazina inna makkannakum fil ardi aqamu salata wa atu zaka wa amruna bil ma'rufi wa nahawna anil munkar wa lillahi aqibatil umur. So this is the thing, we have to do it. Otherwise success won't be there. Amar bil maruf nahi anil munkar. And here we learn that we have to do the salah and give zakah. And here, before ending this, we see verily Allah will help those who help the cause of Allah. Wala yansuranna Allahu man yansuru. Inna Allaha la qawiyyun aziz. And Allah is qawi and aziz. So Allah has all power. Allah can catch hold of us anytime. But Allah is giving the respite. So we have to amend our ways. We have to rectify our mistakes. So here we see how the effects of sins will be there. So Allah says clearly from the first ayah which I refer. Let me give you a quick review of this. And whatever Allah says, whatever I have given you is from Allah. But you are doing yourself zulm. How we are doing? Bima kasabu. Kasabat aidihim. And vayafu an kasira. So Allah said, "Wama asabakum min musibatin fabima kasabat." Whatever the misfortune befalls you, it is because what your hands have earned. And He is ready to forgive us. He pardons much. Allah pardons us. Allah forgive us. So we have to yafu an kaseera. We have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. And Allah says again and again, because of your own kasaba, you aidihim and kasaba. So it is one we are. And also here Allah mentioned, Zahar al fasadul barri wal bahri bima kasaba. Bima kasabat aidi an nasi. Because of your spreading the corruption in the land, in the sea, sin, disobedience, because of kasabat aidi an nasi liyuzikhanna ba'd allazi amilu la'allahum yarjun. But what we learn from different ayahs, you have to do amar bil maruf nahi anil munkar, and also establish salah, give zakah. Only if you are on Quran and Sunnah, you can overcome with the sins. And the most important thing, why Allah test you, to ask forgiveness. So that yarji'un, we go towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because one day we will be gathered in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to prepare ourselves for that day. Jazakallah khairan kaseera.